Welcome to tonight's program. My name is Gary Privo. I'm the director of the Global Awareness Lecture Series. Tonight's program is being presented to you in a co-sponsorship with the Upper Midwest chapter of the Witness for Peace organization. You'll learn a little bit more about that in a minute or so. And the CSB SJU International Affairs Club. I'd now like to pass the introduction of tonight's speaker, Francisco Cerezo from the Comité Cerezo, to Elise Roberts, who is the Upper Midwest director of the Witness for Peace organization.
Hi, thanks so much for having us tonight. It's so great to have to pull in extra chairs for an event. We love seeing such a full room. This is probably our fourth time to St. John's campus in the last few years. It's always such a joy to be here. The students are always really engaged in the work that we're doing, so happy to be back. I'm just going to take about 5 minutes to tell you a little bit about Witness for Peace and the work that we're doing in our history, and a little bit about how you can get involved in our work. And then I'm going to hand it off to Maggie Irvin, who's my colleague from the Mexico team. She's based out of Oaxaca and works there with our partners on the ground in Mexico. And then Francisco's presentation is about 40 minutes long, and we'll have some good time for some questions afterwards and a discussion about what we can do to support peace and justice issues in Mexico and throughout Latin America. Witness for Peace was founded 30 years ago. We're really excited to be celebrating our 30th anniversary this year. And we were founded during the Contra War in Nicaragua, wanting U.S. citizens to see the effect of military intervention and violence tied to military aid during the Contra War. Since then, we've expanded. We currently have teams in Colombia, Nicaragua, Honduras, Mexico, and Cuba. And our mission is to support peace, justice, and sustainable economies by changing U.S. policies and corporate practices that lead to poverty, oppression, and human rights violations. So we're specifically focused around the effects of U.S. foreign policy and the effects of U.S. corporations in Latin America. So there are many human rights violations, many issues of injustice throughout the world, and we're specifically focused on things that are tied to our government and our companies. As you can imagine, based on our mission, we do a lot of work around military aid and the effects of U.S. military aid, mostly at this point tied to the war on drugs. So starting in Colombia and the Andean region, and then over the past decade or so throughout Central America and in Mexico. Along with drug war policies, we focus on free trade agreements. So starting with NAFTA, the free trade agreement with Mexico that many of you are familiar with, and then most recently, CAFTA-DR, which is the free trade agreement we have with many Central American countries and the Dominican Republic. And then in the last few years, we've signed bilateral trade agreements. So starting with an agreement with Peru, and then just last year with Colombia and Panama. And so we study how those agreements and the way that we trade with Latin America influences workers' rights and land rights and the well-being of communities in Latin America, especially excluded communities, indigenous communities, small-scale farmer, Afro-descendant communities. We're especially focused on the effects on those groups as well. And finally, we focus on a couple domestic issues that I'd like to point out. One is immigration policy, and one is gun policy. And those are both things that we hear a lot about in our current government debates about the need for gun reform due to school shootings and that sort of thing, and the need for immigration reform and a pathway to citizenship for undocumented immigrants in this country. As Witness for Peace, we're specifically focused on around the effects on Latin Americans and the effects of these U.S. policies on violence and human rights violations throughout the hemisphere. So, for example, the way that we control our border, the Mexican-U.S. border, influences the routes that folks take on their way to the U.S. It influences the violence that they face, the resources that they are accessible to, whether or not they're passing through cities or through desert. And our gun policy, in similar ways, there are many reasons to have gun reform in this country, and we focus on specifically the effects on Latin American communities. So in Mexico, for example, as an everyday citizen, you don't have the right to carry arms. And because we have that right here in the US, our guns flow freely over the border from the US to Mexico. And so there's this access to illegal arms that is based on our freedom to have the right to bear arms. Currently, 90% of guns in Mexico are coming from the US. And so just that capacity to be violent and to have illegal arms when there aren't legal arms is greatly influenced by the U.S. policies around those issues. So the way that we do our work is we take delegations to Latin America. Over on the table over here, and I might just pass them out as well, there's some information about upcoming delegations to Latin America. We take 10-day trips for people living in the U.S. to see the effects of U.S. policies. There's one going over January that's themed on Monsanto, free trade, and building food justice solidarity between the Midwest and Mexican farming communities. Then there's one in March that is themed around NAFTA and the roots of migration. So there are a lot of different ways to go and learn from our neighbors in Latin America about how our policies are affecting their communities. And then we do what we're doing here today with Francisco Cerezo, who is an amazingly talented, well-known human rights defender from Mexico City. He's been doing this work for about 12 years, and he'll talk about the work that he's doing today. And we're on about day 20 out of 25 days traveling around the Midwest. We've spoken to about 2,000 students and community members thus far, and it's meant to build awareness about the effects of policy to a broader audience. And both of those things are meant to inform U.S. citizens about the effects of our policies and push for change. So we're also interested in meeting with Congress members, having actions in solidarity, and doing whatever we can to build awareness and support peace and justice throughout the hemisphere. So I'm gonna hand it off to Maggie. I am gonna pass around a sign-in sheet to get our emails. I don't send a ton of emails. I'll just send them to you when there's an urgent need for action based on your congressional district, or based on one of our partners, or if there's an event happening around this area. So if you give me your zip code especially, I can target it so I won't harass you about stuff happening in other areas of the Midwest. I'm gonna go ahead and pass it off to Maggie Irvin from our Mexico team. Thanks so much.
I'm going to be really brief because I want to leave the great majority of time for Francisco, but I just want to give you a really quick framework about why we're in Mexico at all as Witness for Peace. So it's probably not that hard to convince you that the relationship of the U.S. and Mexico is very intertwined and very interdependent. Over more than a third of U.S. territory used to be Mexico, for one thing. And out of the 112 million Mexicans, does anybody know how many live in the U.S.? Anybody want to guess? 20 million? Cut it in about in half. It's about 11 million, which is about 10% of Mexican citizens who live in the U.S. Obviously ties, their family ties are very close as well. So the three things that we look at as a Mexico team are the three issues that we primarily look at are the roots of migration. So looking at why so many Mexicans have to uproot themselves and leave their families and their communities and risk their lives to come across the border. So what are the causes of that? Because often from here, what we look at is, you know, once immigrants are here, how do we address that issue? But we really look at what causes migration in the first place. Another thing we look at is food sovereignty. So for example, before NAFTA, which is the free trade agreement that Elise mentioned, which is gonna turn 20 years old this January, on January 1st, before NAFTA, 0% of corn in Mexico was imported. Now, 20 years later, 30% of the corn in Mexico is imported. You might say, well, what's the big deal? Well, the big deal is so many Mexican small farmers used to grow corn. And now it's no longer viable for them to grow corn because they lose money on it. So what does that mean for the way of life, for the culture, for relationship to food, and what does that more importantly even mean for small farmers that either have to move to cities within Mexico or come to the United States? The last thing we look at is the drug war. And principally, we really try to tease apart the rhetoric around the drug war from the realities of the drug war. And Francisco will be addressing tonight that discrepancy that is there between, again, the rhetoric and the realities. So with that, I will pass it off to Francisco. How many of you speak Spanish or are learning Spanish? Okay, excellent. Francisco understands English and speaks English very well, but we wanted to make this a bilingual presentation, partly so you all can hear it in Spanish. And yeah, there you go. If I look out at you like I'm looking for a word, feel free to help me out. So without further ado, here's Francisco Cerezo.
Bueno, pues buenas noches.
Good evening.
Buenas noches y gracias por invitarme aquí a su casa.
Good evening and thank you for having me here at your home.
¿Alguno de ustedes sabe lo que es la Iniciativa Mérida?
Do any of you know what the Merida Initiative is?
Que levante la mano.
You can raise your hand.
Parece que uno okay. Salva el honor de la escuela. Una persona.
One person?
Salva el honor de la escuela.
Oh, saves the honor of the school.
¿Alguien escuchó lo que era el Plan Colombia?
Did anybody hear about what Plan Colombia was?
Bueno, en el año 2007,
well, in the year 2007,
el gobierno de Estados Unidos y el gobierno mexicano,
the US government and the Mexican government,
suscribieron un acuerdo,
signed an agreement,
para que el gobierno norteamericano le diera mucho dinero.
So that the US government would give a lot of money
a el gobierno mexicano,
to the Mexican government,
con el objetivo de luchar contra el narcotráfico.
With the purpose of fighting the drug cartels.
Todo donde vean ese logotipo,
anytime you see this logo,
quiere decir que la información proviene,
it means that the information comes from,
de fuentes oficiales del Estado norteamericano.
Official sources of the US government.
Se supone que la Iniciativa Mérida,
supposedly the Merida Initiative,
iba a ayudar no solo a luchar contra el narcotráfico,
was not only going to help in fighting drug traffickers,
sino también iba a ayudar a proteger los derechos humanos en México.
But also it was going to help protect human rights in Mexico.
Hay cuatro pilares fundamentales de la Iniciativa Mérida.
There are four fundamental pillars of the Merida Initiative.
El primero y el más importante,
the first and the most important,
era la lucha contra los cárteles de la droga.
Was the fight against the drug cartels.
El segundo, que es fortalecimiento de las instituciones,
the second one, which is the strengthening of institutions,
se refería más a que México no fuera tan corrupto.
Referred mostly to try to make Mexico less corrupt.
El tercero era cerrar la frontera norteamericana para evitar la migración.
The third had to do with closing the border, the US border, so that Mexicans wouldn't be able to cross.
Y el cuarto, se supone que en el cuarto,
and supposedly in the fourth,
estaba el respeto a los derechos humanos.
There was respect for human rights.
La Iniciativa Mérida dijo,
the Merida Initiative said,
que iba a fortalecer el respeto a los derechos humanos en México,
that it was going to strengthen respect for human rights in Mexico,
a través de dar capacitación y entrenamiento,
by giving workshops and training,
a soldados y policías mexicanos,
to soldiers and police in Mexico,
para que protegieran los derechos humanos,
so that they would protect human rights.
Sin embargo, en México las cosas son un poco diferentes.
However, in Mexico, things are a bit different.
Con el dinero de la Iniciativa Mérida,
with the Merida Initiative money,
lo que ha pasado en México es un proceso de militarización.
What's happened in Mexico is a process of militarization.
¿Sí entienden lo que es militarización?
Do you understand what militarization is?
Bueno, para aquellos que no lo entiendan.
Okay, so for those who don't understand.
La militarización en México,
militarization in Mexico,
es cuando el ejército,
is when the army,
intenta controlar política, social y económicamente,
tries to control both politically, economically and socially,
todas las esferas de la vida,
all aspects of life,
incluso de las relaciones entre las comunidades y las personas,
including relationships between communities and between people.
Es como un golpe de estado blando, le llaman.
It's like a soft coup, they call it.
Donde, si bien el ejército no tiene la presidencia,
in which, if indeed the army doesn't have, isn't in the presidency,
de hecho controla o tiene las riendas del país.
De facto, it controls or is holding the reins of the country.
Gracias a la Iniciativa Mérida,
thanks to the Merida Initiative,
se inició a partir del 2008.
In 2008.
La guerra contra las drogas.
The war on drugs was started.
Después se le cambió el nombre de guerra.
Afterwards, they changed the name war.
debido a que si algún civil es asesinado en esa guerra,
due to the fact if there's a civilian who's killed in this war,
hay una responsabilidad de ante la Corte Penal Internacional.
There is responsibility in the International Court of Justice.
Criminal Court,
thank you.
Debido a que, pues, en un combate entre dos ejércitos,
due to the fact that when there's combat in between two armies,
matar civiles es un delito.
And civilians are killed, it's a crime.
Y entonces le cambiaron el nombre de guerra a lucha.
So they changed the name from war to struggle or conflict.
Supuestamente para evitar esa responsabilidad.
Supposedly to avoid this responsibility.
En México, en los últimos 6 años,
in Mexico, over the last 6 years,
según cifras oficiales,
according to official figures,
tenemos más de 60,000 ejecutados.
There are more than 60,000 people who've been killed.
Más de 25,000 desaparecidos.
More than 25,000 disappeared.
Y más de 150,000 personas desplazadas de sus lugares de origen.
And more than 150,000 people who've been displaced from their communities of origin.
¿Sí entienden lo que es una desaparición forzada?
Do you understand what a forced disappearance is?
Para aquellos los que no lo conocen.
So for those who aren't familiar with it.
Es cuando una persona es detenida por cualquier autoridad.
It's when somebody's detained by an authority.
Y cuando los familiares van a preguntar dónde está.
And when family members go and ask where that person is,
la autoridad niega haber detenido a esa persona.
The authority denies that they ever detained that person.
Y entonces nadie sabe dónde quedó.
So nobody knows where that person ended up.
Por eso se le llama desaparecidos.
That's why they're called disappeared.
Esas cifras son oficiales del gobierno mexicano.
Now these figures are official figures of the Mexican government.
Y usualmente en México las cifras oficiales siempre ocultan la realidad.
And usually in Mexico, the official figures actually hide the truth.
Según las organizaciones de derechos humanos,
according to human rights organizations,
hemos documentado entre 100 y 120,000 ejecutados.
We've documented between 100,000 and 120,000 people who've been killed.
Entre 30 y 35,000 desaparecidos.
Between 30,000 and 35,000 disappeared.
Y más de 250,000 desplazados.
And more than 250,000 people who've been displaced.
Todo esto relacionado con la guerra contra las drogas.
All of this related to the war on drugs.
De todo el dinero, más de 1.6 billones de dólares.
Out of the more than $1.6 billion
que se ha entregado al gobierno mexicano,
which has been handed into the Mexican government,
el 99%,
99% of it,
es en armas,
is in weapons,
tecnología militar,
military technology,
y entrenamiento militar,
and military training,
principalmente de fuerzas especiales,
principally of special forces.
Para los derechos humanos,
for human rights,
solamente ha sido el 1% de esta cantidad.
It's only been 1% of the funds.
Se supone que los helicópteros Black Hawk que se dieron al gobierno mexicano,
supposedly the Black Hawk helicopters that were given to the Mexican government,
eran, según la iniciativa Mérida,
according to the Mérida Initiative,
para que la policía federal,
were so that the federal police,
tuviera mayor capacidad para enfrentar a los criminales,
had better ability to deal with the criminals.
Sin embargo, en una fotografía que se tomó el mes pasado,
however, in this photo that was taken last month,
ustedes pueden ver a los helicópteros de la iniciativa Mérida,
you can see the helicopters of the Mérida Initiative,
siendo utilizados en contra de manifestantes pacíficos,
being used against peaceful protesters.
Después de que los aviones sobrevolaron esta manifestación,
after the helicopters flew over this protest,
para saber dónde estaban colocados, en este caso, profesores,
so that they could know where people were located, in this case, teachers,
la policía pudo entrar y desalojar de manera violenta esta manifestación.
The police came in and cleared out people in a violent manner, cleared out the protest.
La iniciativa Mérida,
the Mérida Initiative,
se supone que incluso creó programas educativos,
supposedly created educational programs,
incluso de maestría,
even master's programs,
para supuestamente enseñarle el respeto a los derechos humanos,
supposedly to teach human rights, respect for human rights,
a militares y policías mexicanos,
to military personnel and Mexican police.
En la fotografía ustedes pueden ver,
in the photograph you can see,
un menor de edad,
a minor,
que fue detenido y golpeado.
Who was detained and beat up.
Como mucha gente que es detenida en México.
As are many people who are detained in Mexico.
Y que nos muestra el supuesto entrenamiento que tienen para proteger los derechos humanos.
And it shows us the supposed training that they receive to protect human rights.
En México, a los manifestantes pacíficos se les está deteniendo de esta forma.
In Mexico, they're detaining peaceful protesters this way.
Y en este caso específico, como es menor de edad,
and in this specific case, since he's a minor,
solamente fue golpeado y se le dejó libre.
He was simply beat up and then they let him go.
Porque si lo entregaban a la justicia,
because if they were to hand him in to court,
los policías iban a tener una responsabilidad penal,
the police would have a legal responsibility,
por haber golpeado a un menor de edad,
for having beat up a minor.
Y al dejarlo libre,
and by releasing him,
pues la persona solamente se fue a su casa,
the person simply went home.
Y no hay ningún testimonio de que los policías realmente golpearon a ese sujeto.
And there's no evidence that the police were the ones who beat this person up.
Vamos a ver si se puede ver un video.
We're going to see if we can see this video.
Usualmente en México los periodistas y los defensores de derechos humanos,
usually in Mexico journalists and human rights defenders,
intentamos fotografiar o filmar a las personas que son detenidas.
We try to photograph or film people that are being detained.
Para evitar que sean desaparecidas.
To prevent them from later being disappeared.
Entonces intentamos pues fotografiar su rostro.
So we try to photograph their face.
Para poder identificarlos.
So that we can identify them.
Y avisarle a sus familiares o a otras organizaciones.
And warn and let their family know and other organizations know.
Para que los ayuden.
So that they can help them.
Ustedes, si pueden, identifiquen a una persona.
So if you can identify a person.
Con una camiseta verde.
With a green t-shirt.
Que es detenida.
He's the detained one.
Échale criterio.
¿Pudieron identificar a la persona?
Could you identify the person?
Realmente no se puede.
Really, you can't.
Se supone que estos policías están entrenados para proteger los derechos humanos.
Supposedly these police are trained to protect human rights.
Y la estrategia que están utilizando,
and the strategy that they're using,
es levantar los escudos,
is to hold up their shields,
o tratar de que nadie pueda fotografiar o filmar a las personas,
or to try to prevent anybody from filming or photographing the scene.
Y cuando ya se lo están llevando para presentarlo,
and when they're already taking the person away,
Le ponen la playera sobre la cabeza para que tampoco podamos identificarlo.
They put his t-shirt over his head so we can't identify him.
Esta misma detención,
the same detention,
fue filmada desde otro ángulo.
Was filmed from another angle.
Y pueden también identificar a la persona de la camiseta verde.
And you can also identify the person again with the green t-shirt.
Esa persona fue detenida y golpeada.
This person was detained and beat up.
Mientras los policías intentan ocultar el hecho.
Meanwhile, the police try to cover up the event.
Además, esa persona no era manifestante.
Furthermore, this person was not even a protester.
Una de las estrategias de la policía en México,
one of the police strategies in Mexico,
es detener a cualquier persona,
is to detain anybody,
y golpearla,
and beat them up.
El objetivo es que la gente empiece a tener miedo,
and the objective is so that people will be afraid,
para que nadie salga cuando hay una manifestación,
and then nobody will come out into the streets when there's a protest.
Y para los que sí se manifiestan,
and for those who do indeed protest,
también piensen dos veces antes de salir,
they'll think twice before joining the protest,
ya que usualmente pueden ser tratados de esa manera,
because usually they'll be treated like this.
La última manifestación reprimida,
the last protest in which there was repression,
fue el 2 de octubre de este, bueno, el 2 de este mes,
was on October 2nd, this month.
Fueron detenidas 109 personas.
There were 109 people who were detained.
La mayoría de esa manera.
The majority this way.
Y de esas 109 personas,
and out of these 109 people,
100 salieron porque no había ningún elemento.
100 were let go because there were no charges.
Pero todas fueron golpeadas.
But they were all beat up.
Y solamente 9 están en la cárcel.
And only 9 are still in jail.
Con delitos inventados.
With made up charges.
¿Sí conocen lo que es Amnistía Internacional?
Do you all know what Amnesty International is?
Una organización que se dedica a documentar violaciones a derechos humanos.
It's an organization that documents human rights abuses.
En todo el mundo y también en México.
Throughout the world, including Mexico.
Ellos lograron documentar,
they documented,
que los responsables de la violencia en México,
that those responsible for the violence in Mexico,
es el ejército, la marina y la policía federal,
are the army, the navy and the federal police.
Muchas veces en coordinación con la misma delincuencia organizada.
Often in collusion with organized crime.
Es decir, con aquellos que supuestamente deberían combatir.
Which is to say, with those who they were supposedly fighting against.
También en México, hace unos 10 años,
additionally in Mexico, 10 years ago,
las quejas de violaciones a derechos humanos contra el ejército,
the complaints of human rights abuses against the army,
eran realmente muy pocas.
Were very few.
Podíamos tener hasta 10 en un año.
Maybe up to 10 each year.
Solo el año pasado,
but just last year alone,
hubieron 1921 quejas en contra del ejército.
There were 1921 complaints against the army.
Y 802 en contra de la policía federal.
And 802 against the federal police.
Por detenciones arbitrarias.
For arbitrary detentions.
Tortura.
Torture.
Ejecución extrajudicial.
Extrajudicial killings.
O desaparición forzada.
Or forced disappearance.
En México la impunidad es casi del 90%.
In Mexico, the impunity rate is almost 90%.
¿Sí entienden lo que es impunidad?
Do you know what impunity is?
Es cuando se comete un delito.
It's when a crime is committed.
Y no se investiga.
And it's not investigated.
Y nadie resulta responsable de ese hecho.
And nobody is held accountable for this crime.
Entonces en México el 90% de los delitos.
So in Mexico 90% of crimes.
No son investigados.
Are not investigated.
Y nadie es responsabilizado de ello.
And no one is held accountable for those crimes.
En situaciones de derechos humanos,
in situations of human rights abuses,
casi estamos al 100% de impunidad.
There is an almost 100%
es decir, en México,
which is to say that in Mexico,
no hay ningún policía o soldado,
there is no police or soldier,
que habiendo detenido de manera arbitraria,
who has detained somebody arbitrarily,
torturado, matado o desaparecido a otra persona,
tortured, killed or disappeared another person,
esté en la cárcel por esos hechos,
who is serving any time for those events,
lo que permite que vuelvan a hacerlo,
which allows them to keep doing it.
En México hay una iniciativa, un mecanismo que se ha creado.
In Mexico, there's an initiative or a mechanism that was created
para proteger a los periodistas y a los defensores de derechos humanos.
To protect journalists and human rights defenders.
¿Sí sabían que México es el país más peligroso para ejercer el periodismo?
Did you know that Mexico is the most dangerous country in the world to be a journalist in?
Bueno, ya lo saben ahora.
Well, you know it now.
Y este mecanismo supuestamente iba a proteger a los periodistas y a los defensores.
So this mechanism was supposedly going to protect journalists and human rights defenders.
La iniciativa Mérida dice que ha apoyado este esfuerzo.
The Merida Initiative says that it supported the efforts.
Pero la realidad en México es que las organizaciones de derechos humanos,
but the reality is that in Mexico it was the organizations, the human rights organizations,
fuimos los que escribimos
We were the ones who wrote
e impulsamos esta ley.
And pushed for this law.
Ahora ya existe.
Now it's in place.
Tiene dinero de la iniciativa Mérida.
And it has money from the Mérida Initiative.
Y los defensores que supuestamente están siendo protegidos.
And the human rights defenders that are supposedly protected under it.
Han sido atacados incluso en la puerta de su casa.
Have been attacked even outside the doors of their own homes.
Es decir, en México tenemos que impulsar muy fuerte para que exista una ley.
In other words, in Mexico, we have to push very hard so that a law is passed.
Y cuando ya esté la ley, tenemos que empujar mucho para que se cumpla.
And then once it's in place, we have to work really hard for it to be complied with.
Porque puede estar escrito y no cumplirse.
Because it can be written, but then not...
y no ser efectivo.
Yeah, and not be effective.
Pueden ver la fotografía, un policía de México.
In this photograph, you can see a Mexican policeman.
Está disparando balas de goma.
Who's shooting rubber bullets?
En México, en las represiones, es muy nuevo el uso de las balas de goma.
In Mexico, when during the repressions, this is very new, this use of rubber bullets.
Sin embargo, los policías están disparando a la cabeza de la gente.
However, the police are shooting at people's heads.
El primero de diciembre, cuando entró el nuevo presidente,
on December 1st, when the new president was taking his oath of office,
un policía le disparó en la cabeza a un manifestante.
A police shot at the head of a protester.
Y pues el manifestante ahorita sigue, se debate entre la vida y la muerte.
And that protester is still fighting for his life.
Afortunadamente, otro manifestante logró filmar el hecho.
Fortunately, another protester filmed the event.
¿De dónde salió el disparo? ¿Cómo le pegó?
Both where the bullet came from and how it hit his friend.
Y se abrió una investigación judicial para sancionar esos policías.
An investigation was opened to sanction the police.
Días antes de que el testigo fuera ante la justicia,
a few days before this witness was going to testify in court,
fue detenido y desaparecido.
He was detained and disappeared.
Porque en México, si no hay testigos de los hechos,
because in Mexico, if there's no witnesses to the events,
no hay investigación.
The crimes, there's no investigation.
Y por lo tanto, no va a haber ningún responsable.
And therefore, nobody will pay for it.
La iniciativa Mérida nos dice,
the Mérida Initiative says,
que el gobierno norteamericano,
that the US government,
se preocupa mucho por el respeto a los derechos humanos en otros países.
Is very concerned about respect for human rights in other countries.
Y en este caso, en México.
In this case, in Mexico.
Amnistía Internacional logró documentar.
But Amnesty International documented
que a pesar de que parte de este dinero de la iniciativa Mérida,
that in spite of the fact that part of the Mérida Initiative money
estaba condicionado a que México respetara los derechos humanos,
was tied on the condition that Mexico respect human rights,
y a pesar de que México reprobó este examen,
and even though Mexico failed to meet these conditions,
el Congreso norteamericano sugirió que se le diera de todos modos el dinero.
The US Congress decided that this money would be released anyway.
Los Estados Unidos hacen un informe sobre el estado de derechos humanos en el mundo.
The US State Department puts out reports every year about the state of human rights throughout the world.
En el reporte del año pasado,
in last year's report,
nuestra organización es una fuente confiable.
Our organization was a reliable source.
Sobre los casos documentados de ataques a defensores de derechos humanos.
About documented cases of attacks against human rights defenders.
Entre el 2008 y el 2011.
Between 2008 and 2011.
Documentamos 326 casos.
We documented 326 cases.
El año pasado.
Last year.
Solo entre junio del 2012 y mayo de este año.
Just between June 2012 and May of this year.
Es decir, en un año.
Which is to say, one year.
Documentamos 499 casos.
We documented 499 cases.
350 personas fueron detenidas de manera arbitraria.
350 people were arbitrarily detained.
124 defensores fueron amenazados de muerte.
124 human rights defenders were received death threats.
Hostigados o vigilados de manera ilegal.
Or were harassed or had illegal surveillance practiced on them.
14 fueron desaparecidos.
14 were disappeared.
11 fueron ejecutados.
11 were killed.
¿Pueden identificar los estados donde hay más casos?
Can you identify the states where there are the most cases?
¿Pueden identificar estos estados?
Do you know what states these are?
Chiapas.
Chiapas.
Oaxaca. Guerrero.
Oaxaca, Guerrero.
Michoacán. Estos tres estados.
These three states.
Son los estados más pobres en México.
Are the poorest states in Mexico.
y donde hay mayor población indígena.
And where there's the biggest indigenous population.
En México, la iniciativa Mérida se ha utilizado.
In Mexico, the Mérida Initiative has been used.
Para crear grupos paramilitares.
To create paramilitary groups.
Grupos que llegan a las comunidades indígenas.
Groups that arrive in the indigenous communities.
O comunidades campesinas.
Or small farming communities.
Y matan gente de manera indiscriminada.
And kill people in an indiscriminately.
Inclusive de manera pareciera irracional.
Even in a way that seems irrational.
Las comunidades piden ayuda al ejército.
The communities then ask the army for help.
Y llega el ejército y mata a más gente.
And the army arrives and kills more people.
La gente tiene que salirse de sus comunidades pues para sobrevivir.
So the people have to flee from their communities to, in order to survive.
Ustedes se preguntarán, ¿cuál es el objetivo de eso?
You guys may wonder, well, what's the objective of this?
Usualmente, atrás de eso,
usually behind this,
está una corporación o una gran empresa transnacional.
There's a big corporation or transnational corporation
que necesita ese territorio.
That needs the land.
Ya sea para poner una mina,
either to open a mine,
para poner una hidroeléctrica,
to build a dam,
para sembrar palma africana,
to grow African palm,
para obtener un ecocombustible,
in order to obtain biofuel,
o para hacer
or wind farms.
Exactamente.
Build wind farms.
Se me olvidó la palabra en español.
I forgot the word in Spanish.
Una granja eólica.
A wind farm.
Y entre menos gente haya en el territorio,
and the fewer people that are on the land,
pues es mucho más fácil para cualquier empresa tomar ese territorio y explotarlo.
It's a lot easier for whatever corporation, whatever company to come in and exploit the land.
En México, el ejército,
in Mexico, the army,
el gobierno mexicano,
the Mexican government,
y las grandes empresas,
and the big corporations,
están coludidas,
work in collusion,
para quitarle el territorio a la gente,
to take land away from people,
para explotar y sacar más ganancias.
And to exploit the resources and make more profits.
En estos estados, bueno, a partir del Tratado de Libre Comercio,
in these states, well, ever since NAFTA went into effect,
que se supone era un tratado justo entre tres países,
which supposedly was a fair agreement, a just agreement between three countries,
hoy en México la pobreza o el 75% de las personas en México son pobres.
Today in Mexico, 75% of Mexicans are poor.
Pobre quiere decir que viven con menos de $2 al día.
And poor means that they live on less than $2 a day.
Y 30% de los mexicanos,
and 30% of those,
están en lo que ahora le llaman pobreza extrema.
Are living in what they call extreme poverty.
Es decir, que viven con menos de $1 al día.
Which is to say that they live on less than $1 a day.
Mucha gente en México tiene solo tres opciones.
Many people in Mexico only have three options.
Una, seguir sembrando maíz o trabajar todo el día.
One, continue planting corn and work all day.
Para obtener lo suficiente para vivir tres meses.
To get enough to survive 3 months.
Y mantenerse a dieta 9 meses.
And have to be on a diet 9 months.
Pueden también ser parte del círculo de criminal de la droga.
They can also be part of the criminal circle around drugs.
Sembrar droga.
They can grow drugs.
Y sobrevivir un año con ese dinero.
And survive a year off that money.
Claro, siempre tienen el peligro de morir más jóvenes.
And yeah, of course, it'll always have the, they'll run the risk of dying younger.
Si no quieren morir de hambre, ni quieren ser parte de del narcotráfico.
If they don't want to die of starvation and they don't want to be part of the drug trafficking.
Una opción es caminar hacia los Estados Unidos.
The option is to walk to the US.
Por eso es que hay tanto migrante en Estados Unidos de origen mexicano.
And that's why there's so many immigrants in the US who are of Mexican origin.
Porque es una cuestión económica principalmente.
Because it's an economic issue principally.
No es porque nos guste caminar por todos lados.
It's not because they like to wander everywhere.
En México, todo mundo dice que la guerra contra la droga sí estuvo mal.
In Mexico, everybody agrees that the war on drugs was wrong.
Después de 100, 120 mil muertos, 30 mil desaparecidos.
After 100,000 or 120,000 dead and 30,000 disappeared.
Solo alguien que no tenga mucha razón.
Only somebody who's crazy.
Puede decir que es una buena estrategia.
Would say that it's been a successful strategy.
El nuevo presidente.
The new president.
En su campaña electoral.
During his election campaign.
También dijo que la guerra contra las drogas estaba mal.
He said that the war on drugs was a mistake.
Una vez que ganó,
once he won,
dijo que iba a seguir la misma estrategia.
He said that he would continue with the same strategy.
Que solo iba a haber pequeños cambios.
And there would only be slight adjustments.
Podemos ver en esa gráfica.
We can see on this graph.
El número de personas que han sido detenidas de manera arbitraria.
The number of people who've been arbitrarily detained.
En los últimos 6 años del gobierno de Calderón.
Over the last 6 years during the Calderón administration.
El presidente pasado.
The past president.
Que por cierto da clases en Harvard.
Who, by the way, is giving classes at Harvard now.
De premio. De premio. Como un premio.
Okay, like as a prize.
Y el nuevo presidente.
The new president.
En solo 10 meses.
In just 10 months.
Tiene 470 personas detenidas de manera arbitraria.
Has had 470 people detained.
La documentación. Perdón, la documentación nos permite
the documentation has allowed us
pensar que la estrategia norteamericana de guerra contra las drogas
to realize that the U.S. strategy of the war on drugs
va mucho más allá
goes way beyond
de qué partido o qué persona esté en el poder en México.
Whatever party or whatever person is in power in Mexico.
Los presidentes solamente modifican el lenguaje.
The presidents only change the language.
Pero mantienen la misma estrategia.
But they keep going with the same strategy.
Hoy el presidente mexicano.
Now the current president of Mexico.
Declaró que la palabra guerra está prohibida de todo su lenguaje.
Declared that the word war was prohibited from all his discourse.
Si ustedes escuchan sus discursos, jamás hablará de guerra.
If you listen to his speeches, he never talks about war.
Pero también sabemos que cambiar el lenguaje no cambia la realidad.
But we know that just by changing language, that doesn't change the reality.
El nuevo presidente dice que México está en paz y que va hacia adelante.
The new president says that Mexico is at peace and that it's moving forward.
Y la gente sigue muriendo, sigue siendo desaparecida.
But the people keep dying and keep being disappeared.
Nosotros decimos que no podemos negar el derecho del pueblo norteamericano.
What we say is that we can't deny the American people
de ayudar a otros países.
The opportunity to help other countries.
Pero sí podemos pedir
but what we can ask for
que sean vigilantes de que su dinero
is that you're vigilant that your money
no sea utilizado en otros países
is not used in other countries
como México para matar mexicanos.
Such as Mexico to kill Mexicans.
Somos una organización que lleva 12 años de trabajo.
We're an organization that's been working for 12 years now.
Iniciamos porque tres de mis hermanos
we started because three of my brothers
fueron detenidos, torturados y enviados a penales de alta seguridad.
Were arrested, tortured and sent to high security prison.
Tenían 19, 22 y 24 años.
They were 19, 22 and 24 years old.
Eran estudiantes universitarios.
They were university students.
Fueron injustamente acusados
they were unjustly accused
de ser terroristas.
Of being terrorists.
Esto fue en el año 2001.
This was in the year 2001.
Y en el año 2001 ser terrorista o ser acusado de terrorismo.
And in 2001, being a terrorist or being accused of terrorism.
Era lo peor que le podía suceder a cualquier persona en el mundo.
Was the worst thing that could happen to anyone in the world.
Iban a ser sentenciados a 75 años.
They were going to be sentenced to 75 years in prison.
Y gracias a la solidaridad de muchos estudiantes universitarios.
And thanks to the solidarity of many university students.
Y de muchas personas y organizaciones.
And many people and many organizations.
Logramos probar jurídicamente que no tenían nada que ver con esos delitos.
We were able to have it proved in court that they had absolutely nothing to do with these crimes.
Sin embargo, mi hermano el más joven.
However, my youngest brother
tuvo que estar 3 años y medio en la cárcel.
Had to be in prison for 3.5 years.
Y mis otros dos hermanos
and my other two brothers
estuvieron 7 años y medio en prisión.
Had to be in prison for 7.5 years.
Fueron exonerados de los delitos de terrorismo.
They were exonerated of the crime of terrorism.
Pero el juez para dejar los 7 años y medio en la cárcel
but the judge in order to justify them being 7.5 years
dijo
in
que
prison,
por la cantidad de libros que tenían en su casa
said that because of the amount of books that they had in their home
digo eran estudiantes universitarios
they were university students
por el número tan grande de libros que tenían.
Because of the huge number of books that they had.
Tenían una coincidencia ideológica con el terrorismo.
That they shared an ideological coincidence with terrorists.
Y ese fue el delito por el cual tuvieron que pasar 7 años y medio.
And this was the crime that they had to be in prison for 7.5 years for.
Empezamos a trabajar los derechos humanos para lograr su libertad.
We started to work in human rights to get them free.
Y nos dimos cuenta que no éramos los únicos familiares que sufríamos esa situación.
And we realized that we weren't the only family that was going through this.
Que en México hay mucha gente que es acusada de manera injusta.
And that in Mexico there's many people who are falsely accused.
Y que hay muchos familiares que están buscando lograr la libertad de sus familiares.
And that there's many family members who are trying to get their loved ones released.
Ahora acompañamos a estas personas.
So now what we do is we support these people.
Para lograr los derechos humanos de las víctimas.
In order to protect their human rights, the victims' human rights.
Como son el derecho a la justicia.
Which are the right to justice.
A la memoria.
To memory.
A la verdad.
To truth.
Y a la reparación integral del daño.
And to reparations for damages.
Actualmente damos talleres de derechos humanos.
Currently, we give workshops on human rights.
Porque pensamos que es muy importante que la gente conozca sus derechos.
Because we think it's very important that people are familiar with their rights.
Solo de esa manera puede defender esos mismos derechos.
And it's only this way that they can defend their rights.
Somos una organización formada por puros voluntarios.
We're an organization that's made up purely of volunteers.
Es decir, nadie recibe un sueldo por lo que hacemos.
In other words, nobody receives a salary for what we do.
Y para lograr sobrevivir y seguir trabajando,
and in order to survive and to continue with our work,
pusimos una pequeña cafetería en la Universidad de la Ciudad de México.
We opened a little cafe in one of the universities in Mexico City.
¿Y dónde? Alrededor de 25 estudiantes universitarios.
Where about 25 university students,
de manera voluntaria, donan tiempo y trabajo,
volunteer their time and work,
para que nosotros como organización podamos seguir trabajando,
so that we can keep doing our work.
Venimos a los Estados Unidos invitados por Witness for Peace.
We've come to the US invited by Witness for Peace.
También porque estamos pidiendo su apoyo y su ayuda.
Also because we're asking for your support and your help.
¿Sí conocen lo que es una acción urgente?
Do you know what an urgent action is?
Es un documento que solicita una firma.
It's a document that asks for a signature.
Que se le manda a las autoridades correspondientes.
And which is sent to the relevant authorities.
Para que protejan o cumplan con su obligación de proteger a los defensores.
So that they comply with their duty to protect human rights defenders.
Gracias al trabajo que llevamos a cabo en México.
Thanks to the work that we do in Mexico.
Yo tengo 13 amenazas de muerte.
I've received 13 death threats.
Y gracias a el apoyo de mucha gente,
and thanks to the support of many people,
es que podemos seguir sumando o acumulando más amenazas de muerte,
we've kept accumulating death threats,
sin que ninguna se haga efectiva,
without any of them being followed through on.
Y muchas veces es gracias a las firmas de otra gente en otros países,
and many times it's thanks to the signatures of people in other countries,
que le están diciendo al gobierno mexicano,
who are telling the Mexican government,
que tiene la obligación de protegerlos,
that they have the obligation to protect them,
aunque sean ellos los que nos atacan,
even though they're the ones who are attacking us.
Y por eso estamos pidiendo que a través de la página de Witness for Peace,
and that's why we're asking you to, through the Witness for Peace website,
a través de la página del comité,
or through the website of comité,
estén pendientes por si se necesita una firma para ayudar a algún defensor.
To be attentive if there's a need for signatures in order to be able to help somebody.
No les quita más de 2 minutos.
It doesn't take more than 2 minutes.
Y varias firmas pueden salvar vidas.
And many signatures can save lives.
También les pedimos que ustedes como ciudadanos americanos,
we also ask you as US citizens,
pueden solicitar a sus representantes,
you can ask your representatives,
que sean vigilantes de que el dinero que es de sus impuestos,
to be vigilant about your taxpayer money,
se utilice con fines buenos y no para matar gente,
so that it's used to for good ends and not to kill people.
Y también pueden a través de Witness for Peace,
and also through Witness for Peace,
visitar a través con delegaciones a México.
You can go on delegations to Mexico.
Ya que cuando ustedes nos visitan,
because when you visit us,
aparte de que tienen 50% de descuento en su café,
besides the fact of you'll get a 50% discount on coffee,
solo americano,
just black coffee.
Cuando ustedes nos visitan, el Estado mexicano,
when you visit us, the Mexican government,
también baja el nivel de agresión en contra nuestra.
Lowers the level of aggression towards us.
Cuando ustedes nos visitan, pues es un respiro para nosotros.
When you visit us, it's a breath of fresh air for us.
Si de plano no pueden hacer ninguna de estas cosas,
if you can't do any of those things,
pueden tuitear o facebookear.
What you can do is tweet or post on Facebook.
Es decir, pueden conectarse con el comité en el Facebook.
By which I mean you can connect with comité through Facebook.
Y pueden desde mandar un saludo a la gente que allá sigue trabajando.
And you could just send a hello to the people that are working there.
Pueden decir qué piensan de esta presentación.
Or say what you think about this presentation.
O pueden mandar lo que se les ocurra.
Or whatever you guys come up with.
Lo que se les ocurra, lo que quieran.
Yeah, whatever you want.
Debido a que también el Estado mexicano,
because the Mexican government,
el saber que otra gente nos conoce,
by knowing that other people know us,
también detiene su nivel de hostigamiento,
that also means their level of harassment goes down,
ya que sabe que es muy posible,
because they know that it's very possible,
que otras personas actúen para exigirles que respeten nuestras vidas,
that people will act if they people will take action in order to protect our lives.
Ahí está también la página del Comité Cerezo.
There's the website of Comité Cerezo.
Y la página de Witness for Peace.
And Witness for Peace's website.
Por si alguien quiere hacer algo en los Estados Unidos.
If somebody wants to take action in the U.S.
Pues la mejor forma es a través de la organización que aquí nos está acompañando.
The best way is through the organization that's accompanying us, supporting us.
Quien no hable español.
And if you don't speak Spanish,
con mucha paciencia puede encontrar una sección en inglés.
With a lot of patience, you can find a section in English.
En la página del Comité Cerezo.
On our website, the Comité Cerezo's website.
Y pues agradecer que me hayan escuchado.
Thank you very much for listening to me.
Thank you to our speaker and for being concise and precise. That has left us 20 minutes to take questions, so I would hope that the audience will now join in, and also that the majority of you, if you please can, would stay and listen to the questions from your fellow students and to the answers. So they will recognize you, so please, anyone with questions, I see one.
And if you want to ask in Spanish, just let us know. And if you can ask in English first and then Spanish, that way people that don't speak Spanish will understand the question as well.
And we do have a really important ask for you tonight, something that we can do today as a community. So in 15 minutes or 20 minutes when we're done with questions, there's something that we can do together right now tonight. So please stay for that reason as well.
It doesn't involve money. It just involves a photograph we're going to take. So don't worry. We're not. Should I give the mic to the person asking the question? Okay.
La respuesta es bastante difícil.
The answer is difficult. It's difficult to answer.
Porque también existe la delincuencia.
Because crime does exist.
Tampoco los ejércitos se preparan para luchar contra los delincuentes.
And if the army isn't trained to fight the criminals.
Pues los delincuentes ganan, ¿no?
Well, the criminals can win.
Pero efectivamente, nosotros decimos que la solución...
But indeed, what we say is that the solution...
pasa por que las autoridades mexicanas, y si otros estados quieren ayudar...
anybody want to help with that?
Que si las autoridades, que ya sea que las autoridades mexicanas u otros países que quieran ayudar...
If Mexican authorities, or if there's other countries that want to help...
ayuden a que los mexicanos tengamos trabajo.
What they should do is help Mexicans have jobs.
Y no nada más cualquier trabajo.
And not just any old job.
Digo, porque en México ahorita puedes trabajar 12 horas.
Because in Mexico these days you can work 12 hours.
Y lo que ganas no te va a alcanzar para vivir de manera digna.
And what you make isn't going to be enough to live in a dignified way.
Mejorar las condiciones de vida en México.
So what we need to do is improve the life conditions in Mexico.
Incluso le quitaría mucha gente a esta industria del narcotráfico.
And this would help take a lot of people out of the drug trade.
Que se aprovecha del hambre de la gente.
Which is a trade that takes advantage of people's hunger.
Si tú siembras y vas a morir de hambre.
If you grow crops and you're going to die of hunger.
Es mejor ser parte de la delincuencia organizada.
It's better to be part of organized crime.
Porque ni vas a venir a los Estados Unidos.
Because you're neither going to come to the US.
Y tus hijos no se van a morir de hambre.
And your kids aren't going to die of starvation.
Si la gente tuviera mejores condiciones de vida.
If people had better life conditions.
Muchas de esas cosas se podrían ir solucionando poco a poco.
A lot of these things would get better little by little.
No hay una, la verdad, no hay una solución mágica.
The truth is there's not a magic solution.
Pero pensamos que es mejor la solidaridad entre los pueblos.
But we think that solidarity between people is better.
Que pueden ayudar con experiencia, con tecnología, con otras cosas.
Who can help through their experience, their technology and other things.
Para que en todos lados podamos elevar nuestras calidades de vida.
So that everywhere we can raise our quality of life.
I'm going to say also just in terms of the war on drugs and the desire of the U.S. to stop drug issues in the U.S., which is kind of the beginning of your question of being the front line of the war on drugs. Everything, I mean, even the State Department would admit at this point that the demand or that supply-based drug eradication has been an entire failure. We give $6 billion to Colombia, and they're still producing just as much cocaine and just as much coca. It's actually cheaper now than it was when we went in there. So that the idea that that attacking through the military the supply of drugs in Latin America is just simply not successful. It's not a technique that is useful or that has been found to be a success. And in my sense, in the 50s and 60s, we invested a lot more in attacking the demand of drugs and providing rehab and job training and alternatives to incarceration. And that was successful in terms of stopping the demand for drugs. But we're certainly not putting $1.6 billion in terms of drug rehab in the States. And if we were investing in that way, I think we'd have a lot more success.
Other questions? Yeah, here and over back.
My question is just about police and military. I don't know if you consider service in Mexico, but like, where is that pool of people coming from? Is it, like, I know some countries have mandatory service, and in other areas, in other countries, it's kind of like the only option out for some people. So where are the armed forces and police officials coming from?
De la gente que es la única salida que tiene.
It's the only option that some people have.
El ejército ahorita incrementó, gracias también al dinero de la Iniciativa Mérida.
The army recently increased their size, thanks also to the Merit Initiative money.
Los salarios de los militares.
They increased the salaries of military personnel.
Y hoy, ser militar en México.
It raised the salary. And now to be a military in Mexico.
Te permite una vida más digna.
It allows you to have a slightly more dignified life.
A cambio de estar matando a otra gente.
In exchange for killing other people.
Con los policías es muy parecido.
With police, it's very similar.
Así es, No. No,
no
es,
there's not mandatory.
No es, bueno, sí hay una obligatoriedad.
Yes, there is a certain obligation.
pero no los mandan a, digamos, como a operaciones en contra de la delincuencia o en otros lados, ¿no?
But they don't send those ones to combat organized crime or other places.
Usualmente les dan, alfabetizan, los mandan a jugar con los niños basketball.
Yeah. Usually they do literacy programs or they go send them to play basketball with little kids. For the service.
Yeah, so another issue that's received a lot of media attention in the last half a decade is the legalization of recreational drugs in the U.S. So I guess my question is, if drugs were legalized and subsequently regulated heavily in the United States, could that have an impact on the cartels, since a lot of the revenue comes from the drug trade?
No necesariamente.
Not necessarily.
La economía criminal.
The criminal economy
no solamente está conformada por el tráfico de drogas.
It's not just made up of drug trafficking.
Usualmente también es el tráfico de personas.
Usually it's also human trafficking.
El tráfico de armas.
Arms trafficking.
También la piratería.
And pirating.
Y creo que hay otras ramas de la economía criminal.
And there's a few other branches of criminal economy.
Que generan una economía más saludable.
Which generates an economy, a healthier economy, quote healthier.
En muchos países.
In many countries.
Inclusive en México.
Including in Mexico.
Es decir, en México se dice que el 40% del producto interno bruto.
In Mexico, they say that 40% of the GNP.
Es producto.
GDP. Is a product.
De el tráfico de drogas.
Of drug trafficking.
Entonces, el legalizar puede quitar un micro pedacito de sus ganancias.
So legalizing it might take away a little tiny piece of their profits.
Pero no resuelve el problema de fondo.
But it doesn't resolve the problem, the base problem.
Que mucha gente también se refugia en las drogas.
Which is that many people use drugs, or no, turn to drugs.
Por la falta de oportunidades.
Drug trafficking because of the lack of opportunities.
En México mucha gente no puede estudiar porque es muy caro.
In Mexico, many people can't study because it's very expensive.
No puede trabajar porque no hay trabajo.
They can't work because there's no work.
Y una salida también es drogarse.
And one solution is to use drugs.
Y generar ese mercado de que también en México pues hay una demanda de droga.
And generate this market that, well, in Mexico there's also demand for drugs.
Y recordar que el consumo de otras drogas todavía más duras.
And we should remember that the consumption of drugs that are even stronger
pues es mucho mayor que la marihuana, ¿no?
Is a lot bigger than marijuana.
Entonces creemos que no es una solución de fondo.
So we don't really think it's a solution that gets to the that solves the problem.
Nada más.
That's it.
Based on the policies, like the current policies and the U.S. congressional funding for it, who's winning, I guess? Could you talk more, like, why is this being voted on in this way and who's benefiting?
Bueno, ¿quiénes ganan de esas políticas? Los grandes empresarios.
Well, the people that benefit from these policies are the big corporations, the big businessmen.
Por ejemplo, el 50% del territorio de México.
For example, 50% of Mexican territory.
Ya está concesionado a las empresas mineras.
Has been given in concessions to mining companies.
Y, por ejemplo, las empresas que venden armas.
And for example, the companies that sell arms, weapons.
Envían millones de armas a México de manera ilegal.
Send millions of arms illegally to Mexico.
Y para combatir todas esas armas ilegales.
And to fight all of these illegal arms.
Está la iniciativa Mérida para mandar armas legales.
There's a Mérida initiative to send legal arms.
Para combatir las armas ilegales.
To combat the illegal arms.
De todos modos, quien fabrica las armas.
So those who make the weapons.
Gana por ambos lados.
Win both times.
Nosotros creemos que son las grandes empresas.
We believe that it's the big corporations.
Y no la gente la que ha sido más beneficiada.
And not the people who have benefited the most.
por esta supuesta guerra contra el narcotráfico.
By this supposed war on drugs.
I'm going to add to that as well in terms of those who benefit from this. So when the Merit Initiative was signed, it was under the Bush administration, and the way that we don't just give billions of dollars of money to the Mexican government or the Colombian government, we give arms and helicopters and things that support our own economy. And so when we were making that decision about what was needed, for example, Dick Cheney was one of the owners of the surveillance filming equipment companies. And so it's taking US tax dollars, saying there's a demand for billions of dollars worth of surveillance equipment, for example, and then making that contract with many people who are connected to our government. And so there's this direct transfer of wealth from US taxpayers to corporations that make arms and helicopters and surveillance equipment, often with links to the US government. And then those things go to the Mexican government. So it serves our whole economy and anyone who's benefiting from that, and sometimes in really direct ways.
There was a question back here. Yeah.
I was going to ask something along those lines. What do you believe is stopping the United States from stepping in and to fight this issue of human rights violations in comparison to us thinking about going into Syria to stop those? Why is that more of an important problem than the one in Mexico and Latin America?
Pues el problema es que pues se supone que el dinero de la iniciativa Mérida.
Well, the problem is, well, supposedly the money from the Merit Initiative
está siendo usado para que se respeten los derechos humanos.
Is being used so that human rights will be respected.
Lo que nosotros estamos documentando,
what we're documenting,
es que ese dinero no es para eso.
Is that this money really isn't for this.
Que al contrario, están creando los policías estrategias.
That actually it's the opposite, that they're creating police and police strategies
para violar derechos humanos.
To violate human rights.
Y además no ser castigados.
And furthermore, to not be punished.
Creemos que, pues como el interés son las grandes corporaciones.
We think that the interest is with corporations.
Ese 1% del que tanto hablan en Estados Unidos.
This 1% of which you guys talk about so much in the U.S.
Pues realmente lo que menos les interesa.
What they're least interested in.
Es los derechos humanos.
Is human rights.
Les interesa más los derechos de las empresas.
They're more interested in the rights of corporations.
Lamentablemente, la gente, pues, está en México, está viviendo ahí.
Unfortunately, the people in Mexico, well, they're living there.
Si hubiera una plaga que nos exterminara a todos,
if there was a plague that could just exterminate them,
serían felices porque podrían tomar todo el territorio y toda la riqueza.
They'd be happy because they could take over all the territory and all the richness.
Es decir, las personas creo que salimos sobrando en esta estrategia de respeto a los derechos humanos.
In other words, we get in the way, the people get in the way, and in terms of human rights.
Y, pues, nosotros decimos que Estados Unidos, pues, no es un gobierno tonto.
And we say that the U.S. is not, U.S. government is not stupid.
Creo que sabe exactamente lo que está pasando.
We think that it knows exactly what it's doing.
Por eso es que nosotros les pedimos a ustedes como ciudadanos,
and that's why we ask you as citizens,
que nos ayuden a decirles que hay cosas que no están bien.
To help us tell them that there's things going on that aren't good.
Ya que nosotros cuando lo decimos en México,
since when we say it in Mexico,
somos ejecutados,
we're killed,
somos desaparecidos,
we're disappeared,
o somos detenidos de manera arbitraria,
or we're arbitrarily detained.
Yeah, I'm going to say also that we have a different debate as a country about like going to war with Syria than we do with wars on terrorism, wars on communism, wars on drugs, those types of things. It's a different process of how we debate that. And so I think the U.S. military is currently in, what, 200 countries? Like, are we at war with all those countries? You know, there aren't other militaries in our country, you know, just like, but the way that we navigate that is really different than having a debate about us going to war on a country, even if we're giving billions of dollars and having a really strong military presence somewhere. And so the way that we frame it really influences how that sounds to people. And people aren't debated, you know, like passing the Merit Initiative wasn't the same sort of debate as going to war with Syria or Afghanistan or Iraq. You know, it was passing a bill to fight drugs.
And yeah, I think it's clear whenever Francisco starts the talk and asks who's heard of the Merit Initiative, it's the same thing as tonight. It's like maybe two people. So many people don't even know. I mean, again, there was no debate, almost no public debate about this $1.6 billion of, again, taxpayer money. So the debate is not only very different, it's almost non-existent for Plan Colombia, for Plan Merida, because the way they frame it, the war on drugs, well, it sounds good. Sounds like they're stopping, sounds like, you know, a genuine effort to stop the flow of drugs. Okay,
All right, so we only have a few more minutes. We will definitely hang out afterwards and answer further questions if folks have them. But I have a couple quick announcements that I could use your help with. The first one is one of the ways that you can get involved here as a St. John or a St. Ben's student is to do an internship with us. And so I'm hoping that Connor, who is my intern over the summer, would just say a few words about what that looks like.
Yeah, I had the pleasure of working with Elise this summer. And as an intern at Witness, it's just fascinating. I don't know how many of you this is new information, but for me it was an enormous learning process of just the amount of stuff that, not only that's happening in other countries that's sort of unrelated to us, because there's a lot of bad stuff that's happening that we can't really, that's beyond our control. But this is stuff that, you know, as a U.S. taxpayer, you know, most of us are just entering that age where we're starting to pay taxes and are actually funding our government. These are things that were sort of are done on our behalf and that we're indirectly responsible for. So I found it to be a really awesome opportunity to actually take some ownership over sort of the decisions that our country's making on our behalf. So I did a lot of congressional calling, lobbying, sending out invitations, and trying to get people to come on the delegations, which are on the table over there. Website design. I biked around the city for a couple days and put up posters. That was really fun. Anything you could want. That's what it is.
Thanks. Awesome. So I forgot to bring my flyers about internships, but I will have it up on the website. And I do spring internships, and I could work with you from here or over the summer is always an option. Finally, I want to give an update. I'll be super brief, but last year we were here with a speaker, Tomas Gomez Membreño. He's an Honduran indigenous rights defender. I know that a bunch of you were here to see him. We were on tour for all of October. And what's happened to him over the last year is really relates to the stories that we've heard here today. Tomas went back to his land. He's Lincoln and has indigenous land with a communal title. And there was a U.S. bank funded hydroelectric dam being put onto his territory. And so his people there, the Lincoln people, started a nonviolent occupation of their land. They had not been consulted, which is against the UN codes, against the ILO codes, is illegal both on Honduran law and international law. And they said, we don't want this dam here. It's going to pollute our land. The energy isn't going to serve us. We want our rivers and land in the way that we've been preserving them for years. And in July, they'd been having this nonviolent occupation for about 100 days, and the Honduran military showed up and opened fire on them in defense of the bank and the dams. One of Tomas's colleagues was killed, a 17-year-old boy who was at the protest that day. And a few weeks later, Tomas was driving across the country with his boss, Berta, and they were stopped by the Honduran military, pulled out of the car by about 30 Honduran military officers, harassed, told to stop their campaign. While they were out of the car, the Honduran military threw some machine guns into their car and claimed that they were eco-terrorists and that they are committing crimes against the state. And now Tomas and Berta are facing 30 years in prison. And are being charged. The case is going on right now. And I'm in touch with him regularly on Facebook, and he's asking for your support. He knows that we're speaking here, and he's been following our Facebook, and he's like, oh, you're at Milwaukee again, at Madison again, and is just super tied to the communities that he spoke with here. So we've made a banner that says, we stand in solidarity with Tomas, stop repression against indigenous movements. And his ask for us tonight is that everyone will come up front and pose with the photo so we can share it on the Copien website and share it on the Witness for Peace website. As Francisco explained, showing that there is international support and awareness is amazingly important in terms of the amount of repression and violence that will happen against his community. And actually, I have a photo up of University of Wisconsin-Stevens Point where there were, I don't know, maybe 100 or so people there, but if we can get a bigger crowd up here, we'll make it our banner on our Facebook page. And it's a good shot of all the crew here. And then you can go and tag yourselves and share it. And it's a really powerful thing that you can do in 2 minutes. So if you're willing to come up front, we'll get the banner out, and I'll go back in the back and take a photo. And we can show some school pride here and do something in solidarity.